It describes everyone's choices of what's right or wrong. This trimester, I sought to learn through my books and use them as hypothetical scenarios to learn about morality. When we're looking at that, you kind of got to look at different aspects, character and plot. Llewellyn Moss in No Country for Old Men comes across a case of millions of dollars left behind by a drug deal gone bad in the desert. So what's important about him being in isolation is it takes away the aspect of like judgment from other people, and he has to make a person-defining choice all along. What I found so interesting about this idea of making a decision in isolation is everybody's choices seem to be different. The Rose shows a good example of this with his contrasting characters, the boy, the man, the old man, and then the cannibals who are just strewn throughout the world. The two main characters, the boy and the man, are traveling across a post-apocalyptic world in search of good guys and trying to carry the light of goodness. The boy being a force of pure goodness, and the man being a hesitant survivalist. Debates of morality between the two occur throughout the story. One scene that stood out to me as a debate of morality and differences in individual morals is when the pair sees a blind man named Healy walking down the road, seemingly on the verge of starving. The man doesn't want to help because he doesn't want to give up his food or lose his life, but the boy really wants to help. Like many times when family and friends fight, the two go back and forth trying to debate what the right choice is. Eventually the man gives in and does the moral thing. I always said moral and not right, because in this situation, it wasn't smart for them to help, and it teaches a lesson. Sometimes being selfish is smart when making decisions. On the flip side, it can be dangerous when one disregards others and acts selfish according to their morals. The road exhibits this through the cannibals, some who eat their own newborn. The No Country for Old Men has a more complex example of this in the killer Anton Chigurh. When Chigurh stops at a gas station, he forces the owner to gamble his life away on a coin flip. This shows a complete lack of morals and leaves him a shell of a human, unable to engage in normal conversation without hostility. What I got from this is our goodness is what keeps us human. Most people, though, are not moralist killers. The average person would better identify with the old-time deputy in No Country for Old Men, Officer Lee. He knows that, like the man, he should try to carry the light of God, or goodness, even in the face of an uphill battle against darkness. My main takeaway from examining these books for messages of morality is that there is no set of true morals to be held. Our shortcomings are what make us human, but we should try to seek conviction in our actions and carry the fire of goodness.